let's take a little journey into our meditation postures, in Sanskrit known as dhyanasana. As in Hatha Yoga Pradipika and Garanda Samhita, it is explained that there are 84 million postures, and out of all those postures, four of these beautiful postures are most important, as they are really for introverting our energies, our panch pranas, and then our vayus and energy systems, and these energies can flow inward, awakening through the chakras. And in a classical way, we use these postures for our meditation, we can use these postures for our pranayama, and also in old time through the satsangs, we used to use these postures. So the first one, as you can see, we already both are in, where you are sort of, if I take my legs slightly forward and then I bring my feet in, so sort of think your feet going under both your thighs across to the side. So you can see what you've done. You crossed your Surya and Chandra, your right and left energy chain. We can choose our mudra into Jnana mudra, or we can have our hands on our lap, our Dhyana mudra. One of the mudra you see quite often, our Buddha sitting into meditation. If that feels comfortable, then our second posture. So this is Sukhasana. Moving to our second posture, Dhyanasana, where we have Ardha Padmasana. So if I take my, say, one foot under the opposite knee, so this is my left foot under my right knee, slightly between the root of thigh and knee, so supporting it. And then I take my right foot that goes on top of it. So almost you can see the right knee just resting on top of your left foot. So this becomes our half lotus, Ardha Padmasana. Again, our mudra can be Jnana mudra, or your mudra can be Dhyana mudra, our meditation gesture. So when we're doing the right side dominating, it's a sakta, it's a Shiva, the solar energy dominating. And if we're choosing our Ardha Padmasana, then we keep switching our between two energies. So we change our legs. So your left, right foot comes under your left thigh, and then left foot goes on top. So that becomes our sakti, our feminine dominant, or the lunar dominating posture. Again, hands in mudra. We can go into our full lotus or Padmasana here. So the Padma is the lotus. So where we take our other foot also on top. So our feet going on opposite thighs. This is one of the most beautiful or sacred posture used for meditation or our dhyana. Then in Tantra or our Tantric traditions, the energy, or in Hatha, when we talk about the transcending the energies and awakening our Kundalini, we have another beautiful posture known as Siddhasana. So Siddha translates as the perfect, and Asana is the pose or state of being. So for that, we use our one foot to lock our Mula Bandha. So your left foot, say, goes against your perineum area, your Yoni Nadi, and then the right foot goes on top of your left foot. So you can almost see actually you hiding your genitals between your two heels. And again, we choose a mudra for our meditation or our pranayama sadhana. So that will be our sakta dominating posture. And then the sakti, when we change our legs around, so then your right foot goes in first, and then your left foot goes on top of it. So our siddhasana sakti pariyasana. Again, hands on our knees in jnana mudra. And then our fourth posture, we have our vajrasana. So we coming up to onto kneeling position, where we're sitting back in middle of our heels. We try to or aim to keep our heels sort of over big toes together, and heels can be slightly open or heels can be together. And your heels are pressing against your buttocks or your vajranadi. Again, you can choose your mudra, either Dhyana mudra or Jnana mudra. And then we're moving into our fifth asana, the fifth posture for meditation. We have our swastikasana. So for swastikasana, this is a little bit more difficult for many of us if you got any issues with the hips. So think if you take your toes inside your knees, of your both feet. So you're hiding your toes inside your between your calf and your thigh area, inside your knees. And then again, sitting straight. Namaste.